had a hunger.
嗯，
Tractress，
我们其实是一个 cheerleader 的啦啦队，在这个病人在努力的时候，我们在他旁边，就叫他加油。我们看他勤奋的这个跟着我们的疗程这样走的时候，我们说，哎，就是这样子，来，我帮你，来，我帮你数，一起加油，一起加油。对了，就是这样子。
我是一名语言治疗师，在医院工作4年半了。医院是个很奇特的地方，在这里每天都可以看见生老病死、喜怒哀乐的上演，长长的一生都好像浓缩在这里。我的工作信念是不要轻言放弃。这是许太太，今年62岁，她因为中风2次了，所以吞咽很多问题，吃简单的一碗饭可能都花上一个小时的时间。他先生就每个星期带他来接受治疗。我希望能够通过这个治疗来帮助他缩短吃东西的时间。
比如他们觉得很气馁，还是很已经放弃了，我们就要讲，哎，不可以放弃，还可以的，你还可以再进步的。如果你再继续加油的话，你可以达到这样子的目标。
我觉得帮助病人了解和接受自己的病情很重要，没有多余的恐惧或不切实际的想法，他们就可以专心的去接受治疗。
在国大来中医治疗，那么就应该一段时间。
在医院里，人生最美好、最脆弱的时刻，都一片片的在复习。不同的人，不同的故事，不同的价值观，都因为有机缘才会碰撞在一起，留下一段共同的回忆。
因为我舌头是癌，有一部分大概是一个西洋大，所以我就医生就跟我开一刀，刻有那个硬块，所以那边又有一个缺口，他又把我的手一部分的皮刻了放上去，然后手又有一个缺口，对不对？然后又缺肚的皮放上手去，阿姨很细心照顾我们。
我主要的工作是诊断病人还适不适合吃东西、喝东西。我护理的病人有的中风，有的患癌症，有的因为意外而脑部受伤，有的得了罕见的疾病。他们很多是在一天之内突然失去了说话甚至吃东西的能力，那种痛苦的煎熬旁人是无法想象的。
6 7，你感觉到我碰你吗？
感觉
这边两边都一样哈。病人生病之后就会一般上会沮丧了，或者会脾气暴躁。所以我们以做身为治疗师或者医疗人员，我们就有先知了，所以我们就已经做好准备。所以我们告诉自己不会说马上就要反应这样子，因为他骂你，其实不是因为你对他出手，还是你对他没有关怀，就是因为他那时的情况，使他的心情很混乱。给他们那个时间，给那个空间，给他去，就是 express 这个他这个 emotion。你让他骂你了，你就让他，你要哭，他哭的时候，你就在他旁边等他，他会信任你啊。你取得他的这个信赖的时候，然后你在做治疗的时候就会很顺利了。
我很想吃饭。
我原本是想当医生，结果却阴差阳错拿到了奖学金，到英国修读语言科学。或许潜意识中，我是想弥补自己缺憾的童年。我爸在我10岁那年得肺病去世，而我妈在我16岁那年也得了肾脏衰竭。其实我的童年过得有点灰暗。
Hello, Madam Neo。
我想，每个人都渴望被爱与关怀吧，所以这也是一直是我工作的出发点。
Generally, no coffin.
这讲不过。
啊。
叫
啊！
你老要叫，
别磨啊！
叫我看不见，我叫你
啊！
啊！要啥啦啦？
啊！OK， 干得工啊！你都磨哈？
嗯。
三蛋，蛋个带，弄两照照大概 X 光，照几大概？
嗯。我们有个职责，甚至一个职责，说要保持一个很开朗、愉快的心情，要很 positive 的态度了。因为如果说我们的态度和我们的心情不好的话，而我们给他们的这个治疗的时候，他们也会间接被影响。如果我们烦躁的话，那他们也会很烦；如果我们开朗的话，他们就会开始看到比较美好的情景。这样，因为我们还会笑，我们还会跟他们一起笑。
好，六，八，可以两套爬红的。
语言治疗师是个很冷门的行业，全国也不超过100个人。我的搭档韵丽是个外表看起来非常冷静理智，其实内心很热情的一个女孩。她在澳洲接受专业训练，已经入行6年了。
Morning, Mr. Lim. How are you? Okay, ah. Okay, we're going to do some soloing exercises. Remember, I did those with you yesterday.Okay, I need your tongue. Can? I've got your tongue, right? Okay, try swallow. Okay, you want your head forward a little bit? Okay, when you swallow and I'm holding your tongue like that, do you feel your back of your tongue working very hard?
The challenge is having to think on the spot. Every patient is different, even if they have the same...diagnosis or the same problem, the way in which you treat them will be different because they are different characters, they have different social circumstances that you need to take into consideration. So you're always on the spot planning, on the spot trying to figure out a way to help them. At the same time, also because I don't get a preview of my patients before they actually come to see me, as an inpatient or as a new outpatient,I have to improvise or to create an assessment that suits them on the same day.
Okay, one more. Okay, give you very cold water. Okay, but it's very thick, like jelly. Okay, so we're going to use a little bit of this and I'm going to ask you to swallow down very, very hard. Can?Remember, head down and swallow hard. Okay, swallow down hard. Good.
Some people, you know you can do something for them. You have to convince them that you can do something for them and to convince them that they will benefit from therapy because some of them, even though they have a problem,And they come and see you and you tell them, well, these are the treatment options. They choose not to be helped. And that's a little bit challenging to deal with, trying to convince them that they will benefit from whatever you are able to offer them.
It will take a while for this wound to heal.
Okay,
admitted for without slurred speech. So you started oral feeding already. Okay, thanks. Bye.
Ha! Very good.
See, not so hard, right?
When they come here, they kind of refresh them. And then when it goes back, they start a little bit of practice, which they don't like to do it at home. You know, but with Melissa, she's happy doing it.
She has a way of patience.
Patient, and also they have the way of doing it. It like certain things she cannot say it out, and they find other ways to bring it out.
Okay, so
if you want to say something longer, you need to squeeze your stomach muscles longer. Okay, try. Very good. Tell me what you feel in your hands.
Moyo.
Okay. Very good. Try one more time.
There was this lady who was pretty advanced in the disease process, and she was not able to eat or drink safely anymore. The doctors, the nurses, the family, the patient all decided as a team to support the patient's decision to eat, even though we all knew that it was going to kill her. So we planned a day that we had a meal delivered to her that she would eat in our presence. So she did, and she ate that meal. The next day she died, because what she ate went down the wrong way and created an infection in her that killed her. That was really difficult for me to deal with as a student, because I wasn't prepared at that point to think about things like that. And it also reinforced to me that as a professional, sometimes you have to respect what the patient's wishes are.
This young 年轻女孩是韵丽的病人，现在正努力地克服口吃的问题。以前韵丽也有一个病人患严重的口吃，是89岁了。去快餐店时，只敢用手指菜单点菜。经过一段时间的治疗后，她才终于鼓起勇气向服务人员说出自己想买的东西。这可是她十多年来的第一次。韵丽知道后很开心激动。
Very early on in the job, I was exposed to mortality and to death. That makes you wake up a lot. If you have, you know, you see someone that day and he looks perfectly well, the next day you go to the ward, sometimes you find that they're not there, and then you ask the nurse, and the nurse says, well, this happened, or they passed away unexpectedly. That has a very big impact on the way I run my life, or the way I see life, is that you cannot leave things till later. If you have something that you need to say or to express to the people that you love or your family, I think you need to show it then you can't say, well, okay, when I finish this, then I will go and do that. Or be able to plan so far in the future as to 10 years down the line what I'm going to do, I really don't know, because life don't know what's going to happen the next day.
今天早上，83岁的 Madam Niu 来照 X 光，以确定她可以再次安全进食。她的女儿非常关注这次测试的结果，因为老人家一直吵着想吃饭。其实，这种情绪我非常理解，因为我也曾经身为病人的家属。有幸的是，我妈已经在3年前成功的进行了肾脏移植，开始了她的新生活。我受过别的医护人员的恩惠。也恳切希望把这份爱与关怀延续下去。
因为我不知道这个这条前面的是不是
以前我是一个性子很急的人，来到医院工作之后却变得越来越有耐心，因为我了解到每个人都有他们自己的故事，自己的苦衷，每个人都有他们自己美好的一面。
So she can get regurgitation very easily possible.
我本身是觉得啦，人情是永远比事情重要，因为在工作医院啊，医院工作很繁忙，很多人都要你的 attention 啊，病人、老板、同事、下属，这些东西要你帮忙做，有什么事情要寄个 email 给你，或者 pitch 你，然后有时就会觉得很多东西做，会把自己的这个 priorities 啊，混淆了，所以我常常会提醒自己啊，你跟每个人的这个接触的这个时间很短的暂了，我们要去珍惜哦，甚至是家人跟朋友，这时间也是有限的，所以我们就用每个机会来培养那个感情。
Hello, Happy New Year, Jeffrey, nice to see you finally.
Hey, thank you very much.
谢谢你。
Jeffrey 是我去年护理的一个病人，他因为在工作时不小心从高处跌下，头部受伤，失去了知觉。我为他进行护理时，他也一直处于迷迷糊糊的状态。我对他的印象最深刻，他的慰问卡和画栏非常多，可见之前交友广阔。这么一个人突然间失去一切自理能力，一定非常的痛苦。
I only heard of his name.And I know that he did a lot of things for me, give me a lot of help. So from then on, I make sure that I must recover. So I work very hard on it, go for therapies, this and that. Then after my discharge, I keep thinking of seeing him one day to...Thanks him for what he has done for me.
第一句他每次来的时候，他会问我父亲：“你今天心情怎么样？”他会问他哦，所以他会来尽量鼓励他，让他开心。因为通常这种病人，我们明白是心情会比较不怎么稳啊，就是说有时会比较不开心，比较烦躁，因为很多东西他们发现他们不能做，尤其是讲话。如果突然间你一天不可以讲话，你会很。因为你要跟你家人沟通，你要讲你要什么，你讲不出来，所以他会很有耐心去我可以说容忍啦、我父亲有时候会有一点点的发脾气啦，所以他会很耐心。
So initially you had problems eating because there was a tube in your throat, right?
我们的工作是给人家一个希望，一帮助人家了解说希望在哪里，你之后还可以能做什么东西，因为往往在生病的那个初步的时候，就是好像很多乌云这样子，你什么都看不清楚，所以我们工作是真的给他们一个希望。 All right. Okay. Okay. This is for you to do homework. 很多病人，连一句话都说不出，一个字都说不出，或者一个声音都发不出来，或者喝一口水，都很大的问题。所以在治疗的过程中，我们就是跟这个病人 journey 了，好像说 I'm your guide, walk with me, 跟着我走，我会带你出来了。I mean go somewhere that is better for you. 他的家人我们也带着他们一起走，因为家人也是会有很大的 impact 哦。
看到病人从一个声音不能发，到发出他第一个声音，到他能说第一个字，到能开始跟我们沟通。或者看他们从一口水不能喝，一口饭不能吃，他能吃他们第一口饭，第一口水，这种喜悦其实是非常珍贵的。